morning. I am Dr. Prakash Marathe, who is chief instructor for this course. One of my co-instructors, that is Dr. Indeevar Mishra, who couldn't come. He is the upcoming budding ophthalmologist, having very nice concepts about how to start practice, how to improve practice. And whatever are the problems he is facing, most of the times he contacts me. He asks, sir, what should be done? Recently, he has constructed the hospital in Mumbai. I'll just tell you the example. Whenever he started his hospital, he purchased the space. All interiors was done. OT was started. And Bombay Municipal Corporation came to him. You cannot operate in this premises. See the new place, everything is done. And they are asking him not to operate. Why? Because he thought it's the clinic, it's the daycare center, and he can operate. His concept was pretty clear. But according to law, one cannot operate in Maharashtra because there are only two entities. And same thing is applicable all over the country, I think. It's only clinic or hospital or nursing home or daycare. Everything comes under one edict. Hospital, daycare, nursing home, and even corporate hospital. And another is clinic when you are not operating. So if you are operating, it is the hospital rules which is applicable to you. So be careful. We have been working hard for this special entity like daycare center in Maharashtra and everywhere. AIOC is also taking pains for that. Daycare center is a separate quality and separate entity. And we will be coming under that. So how to manage budding practice? So if you have started your practice, the person sitting there, nobody is behind you. So we shouldn't do it alone. Some people should be there with you. Some people means your friends, your staff, your brand, something of that sort. If you are alone, it's very difficult for you to move forward. Support your team, the technician's role. Like if you are alone, there is nobody to help you out. Like optometrist, assistant, compounder, receptionist, secretary. You cannot work alone. So something has to be done. And if you are moving towards success, it is a teamwork to take you ahead. So when you are moving forward, build a unique brand, like logo of your clinic, logo of your hospital, your name. It should be bombarded. And not overexposure, but proper exposure has to be given. And hence that brand is very important. Go digital. In this era, there are three generations in this conference. Old people, they just cannot open the app. They cannot check their email. They cannot use WhatsApp. They want everything in writing, like our program book. They have got pads, and they're writing by pen. Their notes are like that only. Next generation, they don't want to write. They're using smartphones for everything. So go digital. So you're reaching to your patients by this way, and even payment. There are various ways. People are bringing debit card, credit card, their online money transfer, Paytm. And if you are saying no to your patient, your practice is not worth much. So give this chance to your patients, pay online. So go digital in your practice. Next is marketing. So online as well as offline. So rule of the game, 5 kilometers radius holds the key. Suppose you are practicing here, and 50 kilometers down the line, you are advertising. It's not going to work. So if it's the pamphlet distributed in your area, in the newspaper, it should be in that radius. Next point is, visibility and direct walk-in 40%, that is important. Then referral 15%, TPI and corporate 30 to 35%, international, only if you have a good support. Now, there is a rule that about cut practice. I just now told in my talk, Maharashtra, they are thinking about that anti-cut practice law. So cut practice has to be avoided. It should be the clean practice to start with. If you are firm enough to start with, maybe in future, you will getting the fruits of it. But if you are corrupt to start with, your practice will be corrupt. And image of the person, image of the doctor, it will take you towards your success. So marketing online and offline. Build relations with your peers. That's very important. Don't be alone. Take your colleagues along with. Build relations with these three things. Very important slide. Police. So in critical situation, they can be your enemies, but they can be your friends also. So tackle them in a nice way. Secondly, second and third picture is very important. Second is politicians. So they can be troublesome. So hand, don't be behind them. Don't just salute them every day. But don't spoil your relations also. They can be of help. Most of the times they may not be of help. But they shouldn't be of nuisance well. That's very important. And third is gundas. So don't try to develop those relations with gundas. The relation should be that in your area, most of the times if the gundas are there and if your relations are good, they don't trouble you. So be careful. These three important things like police, politicians and gundas, don't be under their impression, don't go close to them and don't be far away from them. So tactfully you have to tackle these three entities. So the front is, what bottlenecks? So that slide explains everything. Like appraisal month, work is worship. Rest of the month, work is a worship. This is very important. Most of us are sitting here, and in our clinics, or operation theater, or hospital, nobody is there. So this is a risk if you are moving around in the conference with your family, some tour. Patients, they get the impression the doctor is not in his clinic, the doctor is not in his hospital, he is always outside. And if you are in the city, follow the timing. Suppose it is 10 o'clock up to 2 o'clock or up to 1 o'clock, if you are reaching your clinic at 11:30. So that's the impression in patient's mind. So keep timing. So that particular show that doctor is not available all the time creates very bad impression, and in future you cannot move forward, you cannot get the success. So reduce no shows and late shows. So learn from the feedbacks. This is very important. What people talk about you, your friends, your colleagues, your relatives, your family members, they must be telling you something. What are your mistakes? What are your plus points? What are your minus points? Think about that. Every time, just don't say that I don't care, I am only of this type, and I am only the correct person. I am the clever, I am the meritorious student, and I am the doctor, I know everything on the earth. Don't keep this attitude. Take feedbacks. So managing finances, this is very important. So you have to see plus minus every month, and then only you can move forward. You just cannot be in loss every month to start with. But in the at the starting of your practice, first 2 to 5 years, you may not gain anything about money. Plus minus means earnings and expenses may be same. But that is the baseline. In future, you can earn on that. But if you have spoiled your image to start with, or gaining some money, gaining little more money, that is not going to help you in future. So with all these words, I think I have given a clear-cut message. This presentation I got just today morning. I have just read for the first time and presented it. Thank you. Thank you.